Verse number 4. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head. But every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered, dishonoreth her head. For that is even all one as if she were shaven. Now, there are people that believe in a false doctrine, that believe in what's known as head coverings. And they'll turn to this passage and say, see, because you start reading and it says, okay, every man praying and prophesying, having his head covered. So when they read that, they say, oh, well, if your head's covered, that must mean with a hat. Now, if we didn't read the rest of the passage, I can see where you'd get that, because it's not very specific. And when you think about covering your head, you probably, your first guess would probably be, well, I'm going to put a hat on, I'm going to cover my head. So you've got people that think that men should not wear a hat, but that the ladies, if they're not covered, then that is a dishonor, that she should have her head covered and wear a hat. So that's why you'll see certain religions will have ladies wearing bonnets, right? You have a nice lady's hat, and they'll go into church, and men are not wearing a hat, or at least they'll take them off when they go into church. But that's not what this is talking about at all. This actually has nothing to do with wearing of hats, and the Bible itself defines what it's talking about when it talks about your head being covered. And we even get just a little bit of that from verse number 5 there at the end. It says, we'll reread verse number 5, but every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered dishonoreth her head, for that is even all one as if she were shaven. So it's basically saying that if the woman's head is not covered, it's like she's bald. It's like she's shaven. Why would it be like that if it's only talking about wearing a hat? Well, we'll get into that. There's a much more strong evidence here. Let's keep reading. Verse number 6. For if the woman be not covered, let her also be shorn. So now it's saying, okay, if a woman doesn't have her head covered, then just shave all of her hair off. Let her be shorn. That's pretty strict. Again, if we're just talking about wearing a hat, it just seems a little odd. It doesn't seem to make a lot of sense to me. But if it be a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, let her be covered. Now, I know we're in a bizarre culture, in a weird world today, but wouldn't you say that even today, it would be a shame for a woman to be walking around bald, to have her head just completely shaven or shorn? I mean, even today, I mean, even the world, right? People, and there's some women that undergo, you know, chemotherapy, and they have these treatments, and it makes their hair fall out. But typically, they don't walk around with their head looking like that. They'll put on a wig. They'll put something else on. Why? Because they feel ashamed. They feel embarrassed to go out looking like that, because it's something natural that God has instilled in us.
That's right.
And again, we'll see that as we keep going here. But he's saying, look, if it's a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, which it is, let her be covered. For a man indeed ought not to cover his head, for as much as he is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of the man. Now look at the difference here again between the creation of man in God's image and the woman who's there to glorify the man, who is in help meet for the man. There is a difference there. Verse number 8, for the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. It means that the woman was created from the man, because God took the rib out of Adam and made woman. He didn't make man from the woman, he did it the other way around. That's what that verse is saying. And then it says in verse 10, for this cause ought the woman have power on her head because of the angels. Don't ask me what that verse means. I still don't know exactly what he's talking about with the angels there. We'll get back to that on another day, hopefully soon. Verse number 11, nevertheless, neither is the man without the woman, neither the woman without the man in the Lord. For as the woman is of the man, even so is the man also by the woman, but all things of God. Now look at verse number 13, judge in yourselves. Is it comely that a woman pray unto God uncovered? Verse 14, doth not even nature itself teach you? I was just saying, it's natural for a woman to kind of feel ashamed or embarrassed when her head is completely shaven and it doesn't have any hair. Does not even nature itself teach you that if a man have long hair, it is a shame unto him? Now, first of all, regardless of what you believe on this covering of the head or uncovering of the head, we've got a pretty clear statement right here saying that, hey, men, It's a shame for you to have long hair. Doesn't even nature tell you that it's a shame for a man to have long hair? And again, that's a true statement too. I can't tell you how many times, you know, as an unsaved kid just living in the world, you see guys walking around with long hair and they look like a girl. I'll tell you what, that's a shame. Yeah. It's a shame to look like a sissy. It's a shame to look like a fag. It's a shame to look like just some woman walking down the street when you're actually a man.
Right.
Why is it a shame? Is it because we look down on women? No, it's because we love women, but we ought to have a difference between women and men. No one wants to be deceived into thinking that you're looking at a woman, you're actually looking at a man. It's weird, and it's a shame.